greenhouse's job is to harness the sun's light and heat. They do a fantastic job at this, sometimes too good of a job. Growing in the dead of summer can be challenging at times, as greenhouses will reach temperatures too extreme for plant growth. There are many ways that you can help beat the heat. However, one of the most effective is going to be an evaporative cooling wall. This wall is made up of a bunch of cellulose pads fixed into a frame that's attached to your greenhouse wall. At one end, you're going to have a reservoir full of water with a submersible pump at the bottom. When the pump kicks on, it pulls up water from the reservoir, sending it to the PVC pipe that runs horizontally along the top of the pads. This PVC pipe has little holes in it that allow the water to simultaneously shoot up and hit the reflector piece, which then evenly distributes the water down the pads. Once the water reaches the bottom of the pads, it falls into a channel where gravity sends it back into the reservoir, allowing it to recirculate again and again. Now, this alone is not what is creating the cooling effect. The cooling effect comes from air being pulled across the pads, which creates evaporation. So when all the circulation of the water is going on, the vent that runs along the entire backside of the greenhouse opens up and our big exhaust fans will kick on. This pulls large volumes of air across the pads and throughout the greenhouse, cooling the temperature anywhere from loosely 10 to 20 degrees. The efficiency of cooling will be determined by the outside humidity. A lower humidity will allow for a greater reduction in temperature, where a higher humidity won't allow quite as much, but will still have great benefits. For example, let's say we had two greenhouses that had an indoor temperature of 90 degrees. One greenhouse was in a really dry climate and the other in a humid climate. The one in the dry climate might be able to reduce their temperature to low 70s, where the greenhouse in the humid climate might only be able to achieve high 70s or low 80s for temperature, which is still incredibly beneficial because your plants can still be happy in the 80s, but 90s not so much. This will all obviously depend on what kind of plant you're growing, but whatever it may be, they are sure to enjoy the relief from those scorching temperatures.